So relationships. So let's start with the relationships. So here we are going to talk mainly about the two domains of relationships, that are relationships between TIs. And also this supported by Android since the beginning, but also from this current version, the 2.5, we are also supporting relationships between events and TIs. Events that can be part of a tracker program or can be just a program that is a single event without registration. Okay, just an event program. However, relationships between TIs and events, and events are not supported. Okay, so we can have the events in the left side of the relationship and the TIs in the right side, but the opposite, it is not supported yet. It will be supported in the coming versions, but it's not supported yet. Also, we don't support enrollments. You know that also in as part of the DHS2 definition for relationship, you can select the enrollment as part of the relationship as well. So the enrollments are not supported yet. But apart from that, there are no constraints with programs, with your units, or within track entity type, meaning that you can build any relationship between TIs that belong to different programs, between TIs that are that has different track entity type, or TIs that belong to that are enrolled in different org units. There are no problems at all. Okay, there are no constraints. So basically, if you go if you open a TI and you have a relationship type for a program in which the TI is enrolled, if you have a relationship type defined in that program, so you can you will see like a new button over here in the menu. Okay, so this button, this icon represents relationships. So the relationships are being listed like this is a list of the TIs as well, and you can navigate through them as well. Okay, so you can move in this case Pablo. You can select if you click on Pablo, so you will go to the next screen that basically is the enrollment that Pablo has in this particular program with some data, some attributes of Pablo. Okay, and then of course you can open that TI as well. Okay. Let me see if now I am a bit more lucky with my mobile. Hopefully, yes. Okay, so if I open a TI here. Okay, so I click in on the relationship button. Okay, and I can see my two TIs, two relationships that Victor has here. Okay, if I click on any of this, it will redirect to this TI with enrollment of Pablo in this particular program, COVID-19 contra registration and follow up. Okay, and I can see I can navigate to Pablo as well. And the same, so you can go to this TI, the icon for relationships over here. So I can see that Pablo is also related to Victor. Okay. So it's the way that we use to navigate the TIs. We can also remove any relationship clicking on this button, and then it will remove also the server and synchronizing with the server. So how we can define this? So basically, you know, this is the same from the version 2.33, in which we need to define we need to go to relationship type here in the configuration. So in this case, basically have created a relationship type that this is one has been in contact with. So if I open this one, it has a name. I mark this as bidirectional. This means that you can navigate both parts of the relationship. So from the left side, you can go to the right, and from the right, you can go to the left. Okay. And this is the text that you will actually appear in the Android application this person has been in contact with. Now if I'm going to my Android application, I can see that this is the label that is appearing on this particular relationship here. This person has been in contact. Okay. We need to define like both parts of the relationship, the left side from constraint and the right side to constraint. And here is what we said before, that we have like three different options: TIs, enrollment, an event program or program stage. Again, enrollments are not supported yet. It will be soon, but not yet. And we have track identity instances. And in the left, we could select the track identity instance and or events in program or program stage. Okay. But in the right, it only can be track identity instance. We know that we don't support enrollments, and in the right side of the relationship, we don't support events. Well, okay. But then there, as I said, there are no constraints. You can, well, right now in the server, you only have one track identity type, that is person, but we have different ones. You can select any of them here. So these can be two different track identity types if we want. And the same with the programs. We are defining one relationship type between TIs that belong to the same program, but I can select any of the programs here. There are limits. So it's a quite powerful mechanism. Okay, you save it, and then whenever you synchronize again, you will see that the relationship bottom in the whenever you open a TI. Okay, so let me go back to my presentation. Okay, that's important because sometimes when in the implementation, people are asking us the relationship doesn't work, and many times it's because they forgot the sharing settings. I normally forgot the sharing settings too. everything has a sharing settings in the HS2, as you know, and relationship type is not an exception. So you need to be sure that you are like also sharing the relationship with your user groups or your users, okay, for metadata and data. That's important always to keep in mind. The way that we create relationships is quite straightforward. So you can navigate. For instance, let me go to Jaime, and then you can navigate. You can click on this button. Okay, so you click here on the plus. Has been in contact with. Okay, and then as I said, the relationship can belong to different programs. So then you need to select the programs that you want to. Here you need to select the program that you want to use for creating the relationships. In this case, we are only using the COVID-19 contact registration and follow-up. So I click on this one, and I can then I've already clicked this one. So now I can create the relationship with anyone, with any people, any TIs that I want there. Okay. So in this case, I select Pablo. So we can also show the relationships in a map. So if I'm going to another application again. Okay. Click on the relationships. And now we can see this button over here. Okay, so this shows me the relationship that we have between the different TIs. Okay, now. However, I think it's so in this case, Victor has two the TI selected, Victor Garcia, has two relationships, one with Andres, another with Pablo. Okay, but also now you can see. When we are listing the TIs, you can see also the relationships with the full TI list in a map. That I think is pretty cool. So let me go back then to my list, and I'm going to select the TI that has been enrolled last month. Okay. Now I'm clicking on the map. Okay, so now if in my layer, so layers will be opening. Okay, here we go. So now as we have relationship types in our mobile application. So we see that we have this option here has been in contact with. This layer is part of the is a relationship. Okay, so if I click on this one, click on apply. And this will probably, you will see the results hopefully in no more than 10 seconds. I have already done that. Okay, so then you can see how all the TIs have been related with each other here in the application. Okay. So one more thing regarding relationships. As I said before, you can specify, you don't need to be like, constrained by a program or a track entity type. In fact, in some projects that we have, we are like using also areas. As the other person was asking to us, like, what is the difference between a point and an area? When can we use one or the other? So in this case, for instance, this is an example. So that we are like collecting COVID cases, but also we are collecting areas, like geographic areas of interest, right? So if we define like a particular area, a TI, which has, which feature type is a kind of polygon, and in the other hand of the relationship, we have a point, a TI, which feature type is point, and then how this will be rendered in a map. So this is the way how it looks like. So basically we can see in a map also areas and also the TIs that belong or are related to a particular area, and both will be like will be showing up both geographics, that one for the areas and other for the coordinates that are GPS points together. Okay. I don't know if there is any question about this, or we can go to exercise. Well, I also have to remind you that the word of the day today is data. Okay, don't forget to use, to put data. Is there any question, or should I go to the exercise? Okay, so I will go to the exercise now then. So it's very simple. Basically, in the previous session, you had to create like three cases. Okay, and here we are going to play with those three cases that you have created. The objective of this session is how to define relationship types to be rendered in Android, that we have already seen the theoretical part, and then how you can add relationship between TIs. Okay, and then how you can render those relationships as a list or in a map. So what you need to do is that you, as I said, you have already created three cases in the previous session, so you need to connect those three cases with relationship. Okay, so it will be in this program again. We are always working now today on this particular program, under this particular program. So you need to create two relationships. Okay, so you created three TIs and you have to create two relationships. And let's suppose that one case is the index case. Okay. Then you have to visualize your relationships in a map and then synchronize your relationship with the server as well. Okay, and the submission basically here is like you need to submit one screenshot of the map showing the relationship that has been created, that you have created in the TI, in the Android application. Let me know if something is not clear.
Jose, there are two questions on Slack that I think we can take here.
Okay.
In this session. One is from Arif Azad Khan saying, I would like to capture GeoPoint for an organization unit village. Is there any process to capture the point through Android? So I think I think what I understand is that you can capture a GeoPoint if you create a data element or an attribute. of type coordinate. But that value will not be the coordinate of the org unit. So if the question is if you can assign coordinates to org units in the app, the answer is no, you cannot. You can assign coordinates to attributes or data elements, tracked entity instances or enrollments or events. Is that correct, Jose?
Yeah.
But you can put a data element like we put now origin, and then we add a list of org units. If you don't want org units, but you want a coordinate, then you can also put it there. Let us know if that doesn't answer the question. And then there is another one that I don't really understand. It's from Chanara. So maybe Chanara, you can explain us better. The question is, how to generate tracker has relationship in event report? That's the question, Jose. I don't know if you...
How to generate tracker
has relationship in event report? Chanara, maybe if you can give us Chanara ring. Or in Chanara, if you can give us more details, maybe in your questions or here, if you want to unmute. Let's see if you can. I mean, okay, thank you. He's typing. If we can show tracker data in event report. Yes.
Tracker data in event report. Okay.
You can.
Yeah, but in the, so if your question is event report in the, like in the server, right? So you define the an event report in the server.
So you want to know maybe if you can filter in event report based on relationships. Like I want to see the track entity instances that have one relationship. Can you, I'm gonna unmute, I think we need to listen to this question.
I mean, in the event report, what there are program indicators. I don't remember now what are the you functions.
You can unmute, Chanara, if you wanna explain.
Hi, I'm Chanara from Cambodia. By the way, usually, the visualize on the map is very helpful that we can visual the direction and the relation with the tracker person to another person. Like the mother has the children or the children from the mother like that. And by the way, we want to generate the event report on the server, web server, on the edge tool that able to see example like the code of the children and where is the parent code that that link with that children, so we can see on the event report possible can see like that.
I don't think so in the server size. You can visualize, I mean, the same way that we are visualizing the TIs in the map, you also have the possibility of visualizing the relationships in the map. But in the event reports, what you can do is use program indicators. And now I know that there is a function, but I have to say that I never tested in the last 2 years or 1 year. So basically it counts the number of relationships that a TI may have. I think. Then you can have these results in the event report, but probably it's not what you are asking for. But as far as you know, it's the only thing that we can do with event reports. I know that the Oslo team is working, the analytics team is working in improving the relationship capability for analysis in the next versions, but so far is I only think that you can visualize relationships in the server in the map or basic counts in the event report. I don't know if I have answered your question.